Good morning, dear students. Today I am going to start second component of product mix, that is price mix. So first of all, I will tell you what is the meaning of price. Price may be defined as amount of money paid by buyer in consideration of goods purchased by them or any service availed by them. For example, money paid by buyer for the purchase of pen, or any amount is paid as a fare of the transportation service. This is called as price. Pricing may be defined as the process of fixation of the price of money. And pricing is very important decision in the marketing of the goods and services. You can say price is the regulator of demand for the goods and services. Because if price for goods and services increases, it leads to decrease in the demand of goods and services. And if price decreases, demand increases. Price affects the revenues of the firm also. So a marketer must be very much careful while the fixation of the price of goods and services. So, while the fixation of the price, he must be careful. So, he should consider the concept of price mix while the fixation of the price. What is price mix? Price mix means combination of all the decisions related to the fixation of price to be charged for goods and services. A number of decisions are taken by a marketer while fixation of the price of goods and services. All such decisions are considered as the price mix. For example, determination of pricing objectives. Determination of pricing strategies. What should be the price of product? How much discount should be given to the customer? What will be the price of competitor product? And how much credit period should be availed to the customer? What will be the demand for the product? All these decisions are taken by marketer while fixation of the price. And combination of all these decisions related to fixation of price is called as price mix. So pricing is very important factor, very important decision for the marketer. So now, students, I am going to discuss factors affecting determination of price. What factors should be considered while fixation of the price of goods and services?
So students, first factor that should be considered while fixation of the price is pricing objective. Pricing objective of the firm should be considered while fixation of the price. So, there can be different type of pricing objectives, like first one is profit maximization. If a firm pricing objective is to earn maximum profit in the short run, that firm has to fix a high price for the goods and services so that they can earn maximum profit in the short run. And if a firm is having objective of earning high profits in the long run, then that firm should keep low price for the goods and services. Because if they will keep the price low, they will be able to cover maximum share of the market. They will be able to attract more and more customer towards the product. And in the long run, by increasing sales, they can earn maximum profit. So, if the main objective is profit maximization, accordingly we have to fix the price. Second is obtaining market share leadership. If a firm's pricing objective is to obtain market share leadership, it means they want to cover maximum share of market. Then they have to keep price per unit low. They have to fix low price per unit, so that they can attract more and more customer towards the product and they can cover maximum share of the market. Third, pricing objective can be surviving in competitive market. If in the market there is a tough competition and it is difficult to survive, in that situation firm has to provide different type of schemes to the customer, like giving rebate to them or some discount, or they have to utilize other promotional avenues like giving free gift to the customer, lucky draw, etc. In this way they can survive in the competitive market. Next pricing objective can be attaining product quality leadership. If a firm want to sell quality product, they want to produce good quality product, then they have to keep high price for the product to maintain quality and for incurring money in research and development activity. So if a firm want to earn maximum profit in the short run, they should keep high price for the goods and services. And if a firm want to earn maximum profit in the long run, they can charge low price per unit. If they want to obtain maximum market share, they have to charge low price per product. If they have to survive in competitive market, they have to depend on different type of schemes. If the objective is attaining product quality leadership, they have to charge high price for the product. This is the first factor they should consider, pricing objective. Now I am shifting to the second factor, that is product cost. Student, product cost is also a very crucial factor that must be considered while the fixation of the price. Product cost means cost of processing, producing, distributing and selling of the goods and services. Whatever amount is incurred in the production, distribution and selling, all must be considered while fixation of the price. All cost must be included in the price of the product. Otherwise, firm will not be able to survive in the long run. So, product cost must be considered while fixation of the price of goods and services. Next is the utility and demand. Utility and demand must be considered while fixation of the price of goods and services. If a product is having inelastic demand, it means the product is not having or having very few substitute product. The products having inelastic demand, they are not affected by the increase or decrease in the price of goods and services. So, inelastic demand, the product are having, if change in the price of goods and services will not affect the demand of the goods and services, and revenues will also not affect it. So, in that case, price of the goods and services can be fixed high, because price cannot affect demand here. Goods are having inelastic demand. And if product is having elastic demand is that demand which keep on changing with increase or decrease in price. If price increases, demand decreases. So if a product is having elastic demand, it means the number of substitute products are available. If firm will increase the price, consumer will shift towards other substitute product. So in that condition, firm should fix low price for the goods and services, because goods and services are having elastic demand here. So demand must be considered whether it is elastic or inelastic while fixation of the price. Next factor is extent of competition in the market. Students, if in the market competition is very high, in that situation marketer has to fix low price for the product. But if in the market competition is low, then marketer can fix high price for the goods and services. While fixation of the price of goods and services, price of competitor product must be considered, as well as what will be the reaction of competitor when you will fix price. Suppose you are a marketer and you are going to fix the price, you should consider what is the price of the competitor product and what will be his reaction when you will fix the price of goods and services. Not only price must be considered, not only price of competitor product considered, but features, qualities of competitor product must be considered while producing goods and services. Next is government and legal regulations. Students, government interferes in the fixation of the price of goods and services for the protection of public interest as well as for controlling unfair trade activities. So sometimes government, to avoid such type of situation, unfair situations, consider some of the commodities as essential commodities and interfere in the price fixation of such commodities. Some examples of essential commodities declared by government are medicines, petrol, cooking gas, food grains. These are considered as essential goods. So firm fix price of these essential commodities, and companies cannot charge high price for these type of essential commodities. So government also keep on interfering and regulating the price of essential commodities. Last factor that should be considered is marketing method used. So while fixation of the price of goods and services, marketing methods used by a marketer must be considered. How much money is spent on such methods, like advertisement done by the marketer and other sales promotion techniques used by him, like giving rebate, discount, free gifts to the consumer, giving some lucky draw or different type of contest organized by him. All these marketing methods cost must be considered while fixation of the price. Suppose a firm is providing free home delivery to the consumer, that firm will charge high price for the goods. So students, these are the factors which I discussed with you right now regarding price fixation. A marketer should consider, first I discussed with you pricing objectives, product cost, the utility and demand, extent of competition in the market, government and legal regulations, and last I discussed with you marketing method used. So if you have any problem in this topic, discuss with me right now. Thank you, students.